Hello, welcome to this new tutorial dedicated to Adobe Premiere Pro, one of the best video editors you can use to make professional videos by combining media files and adding effects, transitions, adjustments, and great pieces of text. It is part of the Creative Cloud bundle for both Windows and Mac OS under a subscription plan. As you open Premiere Pro, its home screen shows up with the list of your latest projects made. On the left side, click on Open Project to browse for others you have, or go to New Project to start from a new one. At this point, the Import page opens, where you can set the project name and its location on top, and select the first media files to import on it. Click on Create to switch to the main edit interface, as you can see from the top left corner. This is the place where you build your video with the timeline at the bottom and the several panels that change depending on the workspace chosen from the top right corner. In this video, we will stick with the default editing workspace, but you can always retrieve any panel from the Window tab. Any Premiere Pro project collects several independent pieces of videos called sequences. In this video, we will work with a single one for simplicity. Make sure to set the correct video and audio options from Sequence, Sequence Settings. Pick the right template from Editing Mode, or select Custom to set the options on your own, including Frame Rate, Frame Size, Pixel Aspect Ratio, Sample Rate, and much more. To import other media files, just drag and drop these inside the sequence, or switch to the Import page to select these and import them from the Project panel on the left. All these files are collected within the timeline as blocks called clips, videos and images inside video tracks with V letter in blue and pink color respectively, sound files inside audio tracks with an A letter in green color, complete with their sound waveforms, such as one per stereo channel. To check your timeline content, use your mouse wheel to scroll in time and hold down the Alt or the Option key to zoom in and out around your cursor. The program panel above shows your sequence content where the blue playhead is placed. Click once on the timeline to check different frames or drag it to show frames sequentially, whereas use the player to play back in real time, adjusting quality with playback resolution in case this results laggy. Now let's see how to edit clips with the selection tool on the left. Click on any clip to select it, drag it to move it in time, or in another track. Video frames and audio link together by default. To make these independent, just right-click on these and go to Unlink. In case clips overlap in time, the program panel above shows the clip on the top video track in front of all other clips lower in position. To adjust the duration of any clip, just drag its edges. This cuts content from video and audio files, unless you enable the Rate Stretch tool, or R key. With this tool, you extend or shorten any clip freely by changing its speed rate instead of its content. So extended clips will be played slower, with a rate lower than 100%. And shorter clips will become faster, with a rate more than 100%. To split any clip, enable the Razor tool, or C key, and click on it. You can cut, copy, and paste any selected clip by right-clicking on it. Go to Clear to remove the clip definitely. Use Control or Command and Z to undo. You can also open the History panel to manage all your actions made. On the left side, you have several buttons to manage each track. With the I button, you can hide and show the track content. With the Mute or M button, you can mute any audio track, and use the Solo or S button to play the current audio track solo by muting all the others. You can also click on the Record button to record from your microphone. From Edit, Preferences, Audio Hardware, set the input source to use. And then click on the Record button to start recording on such track. With the Lock button, you can prevent any modification on the current track so that you can't move or edit any of its clips inside. With the mix track at the bottom, you can tune the master volume, such as the audio level coming from the entire sequence. This is very useful in case the audio meter on the right shows red levels of distortion. To add or remove any track, just right-click on any empty space on the left. To adjust the clip content, you can open the Effect Controls panel on the left. This lists all the properties for the clip selected, depending on its kind. Images and video frames show motion to set position, scale, and inclination, as well as opacity to set any transparency level. In particular, you can uncheck uniform scale to correct the aspect ratio of the clip and remove its black bars if you have them. On audio clips, you can adjust volume level and channel panning between the left and the stereo channel. Click on the FX button to hide or show your changes, and use the Revert button on the right to reset a specific property. From the Window tab, you can open further panels to adjust the clip content. With Essential Sound, you can select any audio clip to apply audio adjustments between an audio dialogue, music, sound effect, and ambience. Open Lumetri Color to apply color corrections and color grading. Add color filters, correct brightness and contrast, make adjustments, set color curves, and HSL. These properties will also be available from the Effect Controls. To add special effects and transitions, you can open the Effects panel in the bottom left corner. Browse for any video or audio effect and drag it onto any clip to add it, correcting its properties from the Effects Controls panel while checking the preview. To remove this effect, just right-click on it and go to Clear. You can also add video and audio transitions to start or end a clip, or go from one clip to another with special effects. Pick any and drag and drop it on any clip edge, or between two adjacent clips. You can also drag the transition edges to adjust its length and so its speed rate. Make sure to select it to set its properties from the Effect Controls panel. To remove it, right-click on it. With Premiere Pro, you can also add vector objects, such as regular shapes, custom drawings, and pieces of text. Click on the Shape tool and hold on it to select the regular shape to drag and drop by clicking on the preview, whereas choose the Pen tool to make custom drawings, dropping straight segments by clicking on the preview, and Bezier curves by clicking and dragging. Close the drawing to apply it. Enable the Type tools to drop horizontal or vertical pieces of text. Click and drag on the preview to drop a text box that will delimit your text inside. Click elsewhere to apply. All these vectors are collected within pink clips that can be edited like the media clips just seen. With the Selection tool, you can also select each single vector drawing from the preview to move, scale, and rotate these as you need. The Effects Controls on the left shows all the properties for this vector clip, grouped by single drawings inside. This allows you to adjust text properties, fill and stroke color, add outer or inner stroke, apply shadow, or use mask with shape to extract a new shape from an overlapped region made of two vector objects. Consider that most of these properties are collected inside the Essential Graphics panel as well. This also includes a browse section where you can drag and drop outstanding text from templates ready to use. Now let's see how to save and render. To save your project and all of its sequences, go to File and then to Save As. This saves as a .prproj file that you can open anytime. Whereas to render the final video resulted from your sequence, open the Export page from the top left corner. Set the video name, where to save it, and pick the right preset for video and audio options. You can fully customize these at the bottom, including frame size, frame rate, audio format, sample rate, bit rate, and much more. Make sure to click on the right checkmark to match the same properties of the sample files used. On the right side, check the content you are exporting. On Range, pick Entire Source to render the entire sequence, or choose Custom to select the specific part of the video to export by dragging the blue markers you see above. Finally, click on Export to export your video. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Make sure to check our video description to learn more about other Adobe products and get additional tips and tricks for free.